Oh yeah. What do you gotta say? Yeah, boy. Oh, I screwed that up, didn't I? Yeah, boy. Is it Mr. Liquid Red? What? Yeah, boy. Is it Mr. Liquid Red? What's up, everybody? It's Mr. Liquid Bread and AJ coming at you with the inaugural Mr. Liquid Bread rant. We're here to rant tonight. Bitch about craft beer shit.
Craft beer shiznit.
Yes. Craft beer shitness. Snitch, niche, bucket, whatever. Tonight's topic is early releases of Oktoberfests, pumpkin ales. And if you want to even go there, Christmas ales.
Damn Great Lakes.
Yeah, Great Lakes Brewing Company's already had their Christmas beer, Christmas ale out. They had it at the tap room, so they could have been doing a early batch to kind of, test the waters out. But that was July. It was a little early.
Well, it was Christmas in July, so I guess maybe they were legit with that. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either. By the way, in the rants here, we do this like hoagie style. We try to get a little music going, so I'll try to get that going as AJ pipes in a little, maybe gives us a little opinion on his deal on what he thinks pumpkin ales and Oktoberfests are released too early. What do you think about that, AJ?
Let me tell you. I've been drinking craft beer for a very long time. Very long time. And Oktoberfest in Germany happens in September. Pumpkin ales used to be released after Oktoberfest, which would be October. Christmas ales, late November. And in the past 5 years, somehow, the calendar started to shorten. So we now have Oktoberfest in July. We have pumpkins in August, and goddamn, we have Christmas in, I don't know, September. How is that legit? I don't know. Who wants to drink a pumpkin when it's 112 degrees outside? Not me. Not me.
I totally agree. It's 6 Point Brewing actually came up with a good thing. They had a little bit of a Twitter war going on last week, or a couple weeks ago. And they said any place that's come out with any type of pumpkin beer right now is not using pumpkins from this year, because obviously the pumpkin harvest isn't until October or November. Great point. So if you've got a pumpkin beer in your hand, in your beer fridge, probably not real pumpkins. It's probably some kind of, extract bullshit with some fucking nutmeg in there.
Well, I mean, to be honest with you, though, big debate on whether or not canned pumpkin versus fresh pumpkin are a better pumpkin beer. There's a very big debate on that. I personally put them in separate categories and have my favorite of each. I have my favorite canned pumpkin beer. I have my favorite fresh pumpkin beer.
Right.
But, you know, so if they're using canned pumpkin, dude, they could produce it all year round, long if they want, you know?
Right. And as you can hear, I don't know if you can hear that faintly in the background, we've got Afro Man playing Because I Got High. Because that's what these breweries did. They got high before they came out with these holiday brews. So, and again, the extreme here is Great Lakes Brewing Company came out with their Christmas ale a few weeks ago. And again, they might have been doing a test batch before they went full core, because it's just a really small batch, apparently. But the fact that they're throwing that out there, put a different name on it. Put it test batch or something like that. You don't have to. Don't throw the Christmas ale.
Or Great Lakes Christmas in July.
Christmas in July test batch, small batch series, something like that. I don't know.
You know, I put out some Mad Elf and Coors Anon Christmas at the bar I work in, two weeks ago when it was still July.
Right.
But that was last year's, and I didn't. It wasn't like I put out new Christmas beers. I said, it's Christmas in July. I'll break out last year's. Great Lakes was like, here's a brand new batch. Make it happen. Not cool, guys. Not cool.
Right. I think my camera's frozen. Oh, there it goes. I thought cam was froze up, but I wasn't drinking beer that long.
Dude, it's because you got high.
Right on. So, this goes out to my brother, the Michigan editor out of Detroit, drinking a Ichabod Ale out of New Holland.
New Holland Brewery.
And he was wondering if that was a little too early. He just drank that earlier this week. So I agree. That is way too early. Oktoberfest start for another month, maybe?
It's about 3 weeks. Three weeks out, Oktoberfest, yeah.
Right. Yeah, and that's, you can shoot for that. I mean, obviously, brewing beer, I assume the brewers are probably can spot on and have that stuff and know what date the stuff's going to be in a bottle. So there's not really a week or 2 week or 3 week gap or range where they may or may not have the beer done and ready in bottles. But, you know, either way, you got to be able to focus that in closer to September, the September time frame, not the beginning of August.
True that. And I just want to point out that I am drinking my current beer out of a Corazon Christmas glass.
Nice. Because
apparently it's that time.
Yes, a little early.
I don't know.
A little early. It's like pure ejaculation. It's nice, but then you feel bad after you had it. You know what I'm saying?
I'm sure she feels worse than you do.
Yeah, exactly.
In that, but that's just me. I don't know what's going on there.
All right, what else? What else is going on in the news? You got anything else? Weibacher came out with something, didn't they?
Let me do a little screen share up in here.
Throw that up there on the screen there. We got the cameraman. Get the cameraman involved here. Where's he at?
We're going to try to make this happen real quick.
Again, this is the inaugural Mr. Liquid Bread rant, so hopefully that's showing up right now.
All right, so we have a little Weibacher Imperial Pumpkin released already.
Nice, yeah. See, that's too
early. Brand new label, which I like. Very nice new label for Weibacher there. To me, Weibacher is one of my favorite pumpkins. You know, 8% ABV, very nice on the alcohol front. Very nice blend of spices. Let me switch real quick. We'll see if we can make that happen. Now we have some Willibur's Organic Pumpkin just released as well. I haven't had this yet. I do already have it at the bar that I work for. We're going to put that on tap very soon.
What is that bar? Might as well drop their name in on that, too.
It's the V-Spot in Scranton, Pennsylvania.
Nice.
Very nice bar. And then finally, something that just came out was the UFO Pumpkin Wit.
Ooh.
Which came out first time last year. Very limited batch. This year is supposed to be a lot bigger, larger distribution for that. But this was delicious. Like a pumpkin wit, I couldn't imagine what it would taste like. It was totally legit. I recommend trying it if you can get it in your area.
That does sound amazing, but again.
Way too early, bro. Way too early.
Oh, okay, so if they don't tag a beer with, you know, that fall type of, I don't know, that fall theme or that holiday theme, and they just do a beer with, and they treat it like a beer with just a pumpkin flavor, you know, not necessarily, it could be real pumpkins or extract.
Canned pumpkin or, yeah, whatever.
But they're not focusing it on a time of year. I wonder if that'd be more acceptable, just like you do, like, a raspberry brew or something like that, you know. It's going to be, you know, raspberries are only harvested a certain part of the year, so we don't really bitch about that too much, but pumpkins, everybody associates pumpkins with, you know, the fall. So,
and that's unfortunately the stigma of a pumpkin beer is, you know, if you say pumpkin beer, again, if you go back 6 to 10 years ago, the only time you can get a pumpkin beer is in November. You know, it's right around that Thanksgiving time. You know, you're eating some pumpkin pie, drinking a pumpkin beer, you know, sitting around the table around Thanksgiving with your, you know, smutty nose pumpkin or Southern Tier pumpkin, something like that, you know. But now it's like, you know, Spaten Oktoberfest, one of my favorite Oktoberfests of all time, they actually make that year-round now. When it's not Oktoberfest season, they call it Spaten Marzen. They don't call it Oktoberfest.
See, that's the way you need to do it. Get off.
Boom, exactly.
Boom. Exactly. Yes, yes. Just like I'm right now, drinking almost all head, but this is my mango wheat. It's August. It's still fucking hot as hell out. I go outside and I do yard work. My balls sweat just like any other man. I want something that refreshes me. Mango and wheat, can't go wrong there.
Pumpkin. And for the viewers at home, when his balls sweat, he drinks a lot of head. I don't know how you want to correlate that, but...
Good point there. Good point. Yeah, that's...
Cheers to you, my friend. Cheers to you.
That's a good point. Yeah, right. But yeah, again, it's still August. If you were a freaking kid in high school or junior high, would you want to start like doing shit that had to do with freaking the fall or the holidays in August? You're still like, fuck this, it's goddamn summer. I'm freaking summer break. I don't want to think about school or anything else that's going on in the fall. That's how I am. Now I got a job all year long, okay, but you know, hey, I wanna enjoy the summer. I wanna get out there and live it. College football season's coming up. Props to that, but I still want to milk these last 3 weeks before we kick college football season off. I want to go out there, you know, and enjoy the hot weather and enjoy this drought of 2012 right before the apocalypse and we all die, you know.
It's actually going to start snowing in about a day, I think, because of the apocalypse.
That could be.
So possibly winter and pumpkin beers should come out now because we're going to die on December 21st.
Right. I totally agree with that. Now, I played the only two songs I can think of. I'm looking through here through my playlist, and I don't know what else to play. Let's just...
Bust a Move?
Bust a Move would be a good one, yeah. How about... See if we got something. What else we got in here? How about some? Fuck it. Let's just play this. This is old school. We're going old school. Let's go for all the old school.
I was gonna say maybe you should play Christmas in Hollis.
I just played that.
Did you really?
Yeah, I didn't hear it.
No.
This one goes out to all the Seattle peeps, like this guy right here hanging from my freaking bookshelf.
Or Doug Hansen. Little buttermilk biscuits thrown right at you guys up in Seattle. Y'all ready to get
busy? All right, since we're just packing in the viewers right now, we got one big old viewer in this whole damn thing.
It's probably Josh the Kid.
Probably Josh the Kid from Surly Country. Because
Surly Country.
Every brand new freaking Google device he had couldn't join a live hangout.
Indeed.
So we'll actually drink a beer for him later. So
let's cheers up. Let's end this rant, and we'll be back maybe next week. I don't know.
Yeah,
make it happen.
Maybe next week, something like that. Typical Friday, Saturday night. Mr. Liquid Bread rant about some bullshit on the fucking goddamn craft beer industry. I think next week we might hit up why Google Plus hasn't released their APIs so Untappd can integrate the fucking Google Plus shit with them. What do you think about that?
I'm cool with that. Let's make that happen. And then let's send it to Google so they can watch that shit.
There we go. Oh. Maybe they could just release the API for Untappd only.
Maybe they could release the API to us.
Yeah. I don't know what to do with it.
Well, send it to Untappd.
Okay. Yeah.
And Sean Kim.
And Sean Kim. So Sean. All right. So let's get out of here. And again, this is the Mr. Liquid Bread rant. And we're talking again about how holiday beers, Oktoberfest, pumpkin ales, Christmas ales are released way the F too early. Way the fuck too early. Calm that shit down. Back it up a few weeks. Back that ass up. That would have been a good song to play tonight.
That would.
Again, these rants are done hoagie style. Music in the background, drinking your beer. The only thing you're not doing is drinking right out of the bottle, unfortunately. You got a bottle, a little bit of sipping? Give AJ, give us a little bottle sip.
I got you, bro.
Roll that fucking dough. And I get an email right there. Thanks. All right, guys, everybody take care. We'll see you later, and
peace out.